रखो शरण अब तो जीवन हारे हे गोविंद नीर पीवन कारण कयो सिंधु के किनारे सिंधु पीच बसत ग्राह सिंधु बसत ग्राह चरण धरि पछारे हे गोविंद चार प्रहर युद्ध भयो नहीं गयो मजदारे नाक कान डूबन लागे नाक कान डूबन लागे कृष्ण को पुकारे कृष्ण को पुकारे हे गोविंद गोविंद द्वारका में शबद गयो गरुड़ ले सीधारे ग्राह को मार के गजराज को उभारे सूर कहे श्याम सुनो श्याम सुनो श्याम 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 सूर कहे श्याम सुनो शरण है तिहारे अब के पार पार करो अब के पार पार करो नंद के दुल्हारे नंद के दुल्हारे हे गोविंद हे गोविंद गोविंद
Gajendra?
Oh yeah, this song is composed by Surdas and which covers completely the Gajendra Moksha story.
Shall I tell you the story?
Oh yeah, sure.
Gajendra was a very powerful animal.
Mm-hmm.
One day when he was walking with his herd.
Mm-hmm. Was he the king of the forest?
Yes, he was. He was really strong.
Okay.
One day when he was walking with his herd.
Mm-hmm.
He found a beautiful lake filled with sweet water and lilies.
Okay.
He played with his friends in the pond. His herd splashed water. This playful act disturbed a huge crocodile which lived in the lake.
Okay. And then what happened?
And then later, it seized him by the foot and pulled him into the river.
Oh, he pulled Gajendra into the river?
Yes.
Okay, then?
Then with pain, Gajendra tried to pull himself out. His relatives helped him, but the crocodile was just too strong.
Okay. So who is this crocodile? Who is this Gajendra? Is there a story behind it?
Yes.
Okay.
The crocodile was not an ordinary crocodile.
Mm-hmm.
In his previous birth, he was Hoo-Hoo.
Hoo-Hoo.
A Gandharva.
Hoo-Hoo, that's a nice name. He was a Gandharva?
Yes.
Okay.
Who the Gandharva.
Mm-hmm.
He was playing in the lake with his wife.
Okay.
He pulled the legs of a sage prayerfully.
Oh, there was a sage who was meditating and he pulled his leg?
Yeah, sage okay. Devala.
Okay, and then what happened?
The sage got frightened. He became furious to know when it was who was pulling his legs.
Mm-hmm. Then did he curse him?
Yes, he cursed who to be a crocodile.
To be a crocodile.
And then he shall be only relieved by the Lord Narayana.
Oh, by the mercy of Lord Narayana, he'll be relieved.
Yes.
And who is this Gajendra? I think I know his story. Gajendra, in his previous life, was King Indradyumna of Pandya dynasty, right?
Yes.
So, what did King Indradyumna do when he was a ardent devotee of Vishnu? You know what happened? He was so engrossed in his meditation that sage Agastya had come to meet him. But Indradyumna was so engrossed in the meditation, he didn't see Agastya, and Agastya got really angry. King didn't look at me. So he thought he's really proud of his kingdom and his kingship. So he's not looking at me. And
did he get cursed?
Yes. Even he got cursed by sage Agastya. You're so proud of yourself, you become an elephant. And even then when King Indradyumna asked, please pardon me. Then he said, okay, Lord Narayana will come and he'll free you from this curse. So this was the past story, right? Then what happened in the story here?
Believe it or not, 1,000 years the battle continued.
Oh my God, 1,000 years Gajendra and the crocodile fought?
Yes.
Okay, then what happened?
And then Gajendra was losing power. He almost got flung into the river.
Okay.
Then he recollected his memory from his previous life.
Mm-hmm.
And remembered a prayer.
Mm-hmm.
He recited it once more.
Okay.
And within no time, Lord Narayana appeared before him in the form of Lord Hari.
Okay. On his Garuda?
Yes.
Okay. And then what did Narayana do?
He pulled both of them out and swung his chakra.
Sudarshana chakra?
Yes, the disc.
Okay.
And killed the crocodile.
Killed the crocodile, okay.
And the crocodile went back to his original form,
Okay. And then God blessed both of them?
Yes, and Gajendra got moksha.
Gajendra got moksha. Do you know, Ved? Gajendra Moksha is one story. If we all recite whatever sins even we have done, we get moksha from all of that. That's why it's called Gajendra Moksha story. Do you think this story is applicable to our present situation?
I think so, yes.
You know, we are all now stuck in this crisis of coronavirus, right?
Yeah.
Everyone is locked in the house and we have been strictly instructed that we cannot go out for 21 days.
By his curfew.
Yeah, it's 21 days of curfew. So what should we do now? What are the five things that we should absolutely do?
Wash our hands.
Okay. Stay home.
Stay home.
Yeah.
And keep distance between each other.
Yeah.
And stay a little private. Don't share everything around with others.
Right. Then take a bath.
Yes.
Okay. So all these five things we have to follow. And this crisis, how will we all come out of it?
Well, we can pray, Lord, exactly like Ganesha did.
Yeah, like Gajendra did, right?
Yes.
Like Gajendra did, if we all pray God that please pull us out of this crisis, I think God will definitely listen to us. So prayers, devotion has great power. So we'll all pray Lord Narayana, and everyone can pray their respective gods, isn't it?
Yes.
Let's chant and finish today's episode.
Om Namo Narayana.